So specifically, Cam Thomas is not comfortable with the Brooklyn Nets rotation. Cam Thomas recently returned to a bench role after a string of starts. When asked if he's comfortable with the Nets rotation since being moved back to the bench, Cam Thomas made it clear he is not. Quote, no, I'm just doing my job, but no, I don't really have no comfortability coming off the bench or starting. Whatever he wants me to do, that's what I'm going to do, Thomas answered. Thomas has started 20 of the 30 games this season he's played in. He started 13 games in a row before Jacques Vaughn moved into a bench at the end of December. Cam Thomas this season on the whole is averaging 20.6 points, 43% from the field, 34% from three, 2.6 rebounds, 2 assists, just under a steal a night. And if you look at him on the season, I think one of the big thing is as a starter this year, he is a guy who is averaging 22 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists in 20 games as a starter. And as a bench player, he's averaged 17.8 points, 2.2 rebounds, and 2 assists in 10 games. So you could argue better starting than off the bench. But it's the whole thing's probably defense. And problem with the Brooklyn Nets right now is it hasn't been great. I mean, they've lost 3 in a row. Their defense is sliding. Their net rating is negative 1.8, which is 8th worst in the league. They're 36% from 3, which is 17th in the league, even though they're making and attempting the 8th most threes in the league. There's problems here that I think need to be addressed, and I don't think it's entirely like one person's fault, but and it's going to be, I don't know, I think it's going to be difficult for them right now. I think you should trade everybody on this roster except Cam Johnson. Like I think if you go for Donovan Mitchell and you can trade, let's say, a Donovan Mitchell deal that's around Dorian Finney-Smith, Spencer Dinwiddie, and like maybe Nick Claxton, Royce O'Neal, something like that this season, which I don't think is possible. I think that would be the ideal situation. Now, I think with more and more time, we're trying to figure out, okay, hey, is this going to be possible in terms of like, are they a good enough team? And sorry, I just have random highlights playing in the background, but I think, are they a good enough team right now to be in the playoffs? Yeah, I think they can be a playing team, but I think we realize Mikal Bridges is a really good third option on a championship team, maybe a two. And then Cam Johnson is, yeah, just a 15 points per game scorer. He's not that 24 points per game scorer that we saw in the playoffs. I think that's quite evident. So for me, I think it's, we're seeing what the Brooklyn Nets are. I think it's in their best interest to either play out the season and slowly move on from guys you don't before the deadline that you know won't be here next season, and then this season try to go after a big fish. If not, I think break it down and try to build through the young guys. As it's, I don't think it's a very great plan to just go ahead and we're just gonna, you know, build from the middle, because that's worked so well for everybody who's done it before. I am curious to hear everyone's opinions, though. What do they expect this offseason for the Brooklyn Nets? Do you think this is a team that'll be able to kind of rebound? I think they've done a good job asset accumulation-wise, but mediocre in terms of this season and what they've done. But that's just my thoughts. And yeah, what do you guys think? Also, it's crazy to think that today's January 16th, and yesterday was January 15th. I don't know, it blows my mind that we're already so close to, not close, but that we're the year might be, will end soon enough, ladies and gentlemen, soon enough.